Ukrainian military forces have successfully hit Dzhankoi Air Base, which is located in the northern part of Russian-occupied Crimea. Ukraine's military intelligence said the strike damaged four S-400 air defense launchers, three radars, including 92N6E Gravestone multi-mode engagement radar, an air defense command and control center, and other surveillance equipment. ATES Guerrilla Movement said in a statement that the occupiers believed in their newest air defense system so much that they placed warehouses with missiles directly near the launcher. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky said that Kyiv was behind the strike and thanked his top military commander, Colonel General Oleksandr Syrskyi, for organizing the operation. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why S-400 couldn't defend itself from Army TACMS fired from HIMARS. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. S-400 is playing a crucial role in the Ukraine war. It's working as a protective umbrella for Russian forces. Interestingly, the system has been modified to strike ground targets as well. This is mainly due to the low supply of surface-to-surface missiles like Iskander. A notable example of this occurred earlier when S-400 48N6DM anti-aircraft missiles targeted Kyiv, the capital of Ukraine, on January 14, 2023. S-400 Triumph Air Defense Weapon System was developed by Russia's Almaz Central Design Bureau in the 1990s as an upgrade to the S-300 family, has been in service with the Russian Armed Forces since 2007. It's designed to defend against aircraft, including 5th-generation stealth fighters, bombers, AWACS, cruise missiles, and ballistic missiles. It is considered one of the most potent air defense systems in the world. S-400 Air Defense is a package consisting of radar, a command and control center, and interceptor missiles. It can track hundreds of targets at a time, engage up to 36 targets simultaneously, and launch 72 missiles parallelly. S-400 uses multiple radars depending on threat perception. The primary one is either the 91N6E Big Bird Acquisition and Battle Management Radar, or the 92N6E Gravestone Multi-Mode Engagement Radar. The Gravestone is a critical component of the platform and represents a significant advancement from its predecessor, the Soviet-era 30N6E, boasting enhanced missile range and digital capabilities. It has a range of around 600 kilometers, or around 370 miles. The main radar is complemented by target acquisition radars like 67N6 Gamma DE, some of which have the ability to detect stealth aircraft. S-400 deploys multiple missiles to cover its strike envelope, which includes 40N6 missile that has a range of 400 kilometers or 250 miles. The M142 High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, or HIMARS, is a light multiple rocket launcher developed in the late 1990s for the United States Army, mounted on a standard Army M1140 truck frame. The system has seen many upgrades, including a rework of its targeting software for better accuracy. HIMARS can cover a distance of 300 miles or 480 kilometers on a single refueling, and can travel with a maximum speed of 85 kilometers per hour or 52 miles per hour. It can be reloaded in about a minute with only a small crew. The use of a wheeled chassis, Rapid deployment and dismantling of the complex digital fire control allows HIMARS to use hit-and-run tactic. It has one universal pod that can accommodate six unguided or guided missiles of 227mm caliber, or one MGM-140 Army TACMS with a diameter of 610mm. M142 HIMARS can fire a wide range of rockets and missiles. One, the vehicle can fire standard rockets at a maximum range of 28 miles or 45 kilometers. Two, with GMLRS or guided MLRS, the system can reach a land target at a maximum range of 46 miles or 75 kilometers. GMLRS integrates a 90 kilogram or 200 pound unitary warhead. Guided MLRS rockets have a reliability rating exceeding 98%. All six GMLRS can be fired in under a minute. 3. HIMARS can strike 186 miles or 300 kilometers with the MGM-140 Army Tactical Missile System, or Army TACMS. Army TACMS is a surface-to-surface missile, SSM, manufactured by the U.S. defense company Lockheed Martin. It's 13 feet or 4 meters in length, 24 inches or 610 millimeters in diameter, and weighs 3,690 pounds or 1,670 kilograms. It has GPS-aided inertial navigation for guidance. Army TACMS has several variants, which have different types of payload, submunition warhead, unitary warhead, etc. Since the base is about 90 miles or 150 kilometers from the front lines, use of Army TACMS seems most likely. Recent reports indicate that the U.S. has secretly provided some Army TACMS to Ukraine. This is not the first time HIMARS has been used to neutralize S-400. On July 14th last year, Ukraine's Center for Strategic Communication and Information Security, STRATCOM, asserted in a tweet that a Ukrainian HIMARS MLRS had effectively neutralized the Russian S-400 launcher responsible for the attack on the town of Kramatorsk in Donetsk Oblast on June 27th. Due to its ballistic nature and high speeds of more than Mach 3 during the terminal phase of flight, Army TACMS is difficult to intercept when compared to other types of missiles, like subsonic air-breathing cruise missiles. The smaller size compared to cruise missiles like a Tomahawk also helps it to evade interception. It seems S-400 is not capable of detecting or properly tracking the incoming Army TACMS. If Ukrainians get the exact location of the S-400, and fire a salvo of Army TACMS, it could do the job. It's to be noted that the S-400 is mobile and can swiftly change location, so any such ambush would have to be meticulously executed. Viewers may also note that on a battlefield, the S-400 is supposed to be guarded by short-range systems like Pantsir S-1 or TOR to prevent it from threats like small drones and systems like HIMARS. If under any condition those systems are not present or are not working as advertised, which is often the case with many Russian systems, the S-400 can be vulnerable. Overall, it can be stated that S-400 is not invincible, as made out to be by some Russian experts.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.